Welcome to our second installment of on using puppets in educational settings. In this video, we're diving into the dynamic world of role-playing with puppets. And these aren't just any puppets. They adapt to different characters and situations to foster learning. Role-playing with puppets offers unique advantages. It develops social skills by simulating real-life interactions. It boosts engagement by involving children in active scenarios. And supports scenario-based learning where kids face various situational challenges. Let's meet Freddy Frog and Jerry Giraffe. Or, since I don't have a frog puppet, Freddy will be played by this fantastic crocodile. They are at the giraffe's enclosure at the zoo, and they are ready to show us how role play works. This is Freddy Crocodile. Freddy hops to the zoo. He wants to see his friends. This is his friend, Jerry Giraffe. Freddy Crocodile likes Jerry Giraffe. They are friends. Freddy wants to say hello. First, Freddy has to get Jerry's attention. So, Freddy quacks in a big, loud voice. Quack! Hey, Jerry! It didn't work. He has to try again. Quack! Hey, Jerry! It didn't work again. Freddy decides to hop around so Jerry can see him. Ah, now Jerry is looking, and Freddy is looking at Jerry too. Looking helps. Now they have a good chat. Hi, Jerry. How are you? I'm good. Nice to see you again. Freddy and Jerry like to chat. Friends talk about what they see and what they like. What could Freddy tell Jerry? Freddy was thinking of something interesting. I saw three ladybugs today. That's nice. What's a ladybug? Jerry remembered that questions keep the chat going. So Freddy answered, ladybugs are beetles. They are round and red with black spots. Do you like bugs? Bugs? Freddy also remembered to ask a question. They are having a lovely chat. I don't like itchy, scratchy bugs, but I do like green cicadas. They make me laugh. Freddy asked another question to keep the chat going. Hey, Jerry, what have you seen today? Well, I guess you get the picture. Did you notice how Freddy and Jerry kept the conversation going? They asked questions, listened, and responded. It isn't just about talking, it's about thinking how to be a good friend and communicator. Now think about this. When Freddie and Jerry talk and play, they follow certain rules of conversation. How can we use these rules to help children open up more? Is there room for children to suggest new games or topics within this script? Could there be another outcome to their games? Reflect on how such interactions could be adapted to include more spontaneous input from children. Could they suggest new scenarios or lead the dialogue in unexpected directions? How would that change the learning experience? Let's continue exploring these ideas in our next video. But until then, think about how you can use role-playing in your settings to encourage children to express themselves and interact effectively with others.